Have you ever wondered if there's a natural way to lower your high blood pressure, guard against Alzheimer's, lose weight, feel better? Well, it turns out there is. Welcome to the Nutrition Facts Podcast. I'm your host, Dr. Michael Greger. It may come as no surprise that what we eat directly affects our chance of getting skin cancer. In our first story, we look at the best supplement for preventing skin cancer.
Nicotinamide, also known as niacinamide, is a form of vitamin B3 that's been used topically for decades in the cosmetic field to prevent skin aging. So researchers decided to put it to the test orally for skin cancer prevention. In a petri dish, skin samples taken from breast reduction and tummy tuck surgeries exposed to UV with or without niacinamide found that it enhanced DNA repair. Would this translate out into less cancer? In a phase 2 trial, dozens of individuals with 4 or more precancerous actinic keratoses each were randomized to take a placebo or 500 milligrams of niacinamide once or twice a day. Within 2 months, there was a 35% reduction in actinic keratoses in the twice-a-day group and a 15% reduction in the once-a-day group compared to placebo. It's not that they developed fewer in those months, but more spontaneously disappeared in the niacinamide groups. What about actual cancers? By month 4, there were 5 times fewer cancers. 11 placebo participants developed 20 new skin cancers versus only 2 niacinamide participants developing a total of 4 new cancers. Normally, it would be difficult to fund studies on non-patentable products that only cost a few cents a day, but the results of this and a similar study on organ transplant patients were so extraordinary, OnTrack was born. Oral nicotinamide to reduce actinic cancer was a publicly funded phase 3 trial, randomizing hundreds of people with a personal history of skin cancer, actinic means UV-induced, to 500 milligrams of nicotinamide twice daily or placebo for a full year. By the end, there were 25% fewer cancers with no significant side effects for just pennies a day. You have to keep it up, though. At a 6-month follow-up after the study was over, the cancer rates equalized back to baseline rates. What are the downsides? A study of 500 people put on up to 3 grams of niacinamide a day for 5 years trying to prevent type 1 diabetes unearthed no adverse effects over placebo, though it failed to prevent type 1 diabetes. The high tolerance of niacinamide is partly due to its water-soluble nature, such that you just pee out any excess, but those with end-stage kidney failure on dialysis don't have functioning kidneys, and so blood levels should be monitored, as in that context, niacinamide can cause a serious, though reversible, drop in platelets, which are important for blood clotting. High enough doses may become toxic to the liver, though, even with normal kidneys. Vasodilatory side effects like facial flushing attributed to niacinamide in some older studies were likely due to a less purified form contaminated with residual niacin. I know it's confusing. Niacin, also known as nicotinic acid, is a precursor of, but very different from, niacinamide, which is synonymous with nicotinamide. One concern regarding any treatment for a largely lifestyle disease is that individuals may neglect other defensive measures, overconfident in the supplement's protection. Regarding drug interactions, a concern has been raised about taking niacinamide together with carbamazepine, a popular anti-seizure drug sold as Tegretol. But in general, as the OnTrack researchers concluded, oral nicotinamide is safe and effective in reducing the rates of new non-melanoma skin cancers and precancerous growths in high-risk patients. To their credit, a 2021 survey of skin cancer surgeons found that 3/4 recommended its use. Other than nicotinamide, how else might we protect against skin cancer from the inside out? That's what I'll cover next. Millions of skin cancers are diagnosed every year, the most common cancer in the United States. I've covered the single most important thing we can do, protect against exposure to UV radiation. What about dietary protection? The first study to elucidate the effect of diet on UV-induced tumors found that high-fat diets accelerated tumor formation in mice within 6 months of UV. 50% of the high-fat-fed mice had tumors, compared to only 16% in the control-fed group. Encouragingly, switching the mice to a low-fat diet after the exposure was able to negate the tumor-exacerbating high-fat effects. In people, A dietary pattern characterized by meat and fat consumption was associated with up to a near quadrupling of squamous cell carcinoma risk, the second most common type of skin cancer, whereas a vegetable and fruit pattern was associated with a halving of risk, apparently driven largely by the intake of greens. All we needed now was to randomize people to low-fat diets and see if cancer could be prevented in people too. And thanks to National Cancer Institute funding and a Veteran Affairs research team, the striking results were published in the New England Journal of Medicine. 76 patients with a history of skin cancer, and therefore at high risk of developing more, were randomized to continue to eat their regular diets or switch to a quote-unquote low-fat diet of 20% of calories from fat. I put low-fat in quotes because that's actually a high-fat diet compared to what's normal for our species. For millions of years, our ancestors may have evolved getting approximately 10% of our calories from fat. For millions of years, about 99.8% of our time on Earth, it was virtually impossible for us to consume regularly more than 10 to 15% of calories as fat. So that's a normal fat diet for the human species. A low-fat diet would be less than that, though 20% is certainly comparatively low-fat compared to the current adult average in the United States of 37%. Would a drop down to 20 make a difference? Researchers tracked the appearance of actinic keratoses, rough scaly patches that are pre-malignant lesions that turn into skin cancer, over the next 2 years. The average patient in the control group developed 10 lesions in those 2 years compared to just 3 in the lower-fat group. Okay, what about actual skin cancers? The results were so exciting, the same team of researchers randomized hundreds of skin cancer patients to the same two diets. By the end of the study, the skin cancer rate was 10 times lower in the lower-fat group. Now, this is no clarion call for Snackwell's cookies. Although fat appears twice as bad, high refined carb consumption was also found to be significantly associated with skin wrinkling and atrophy among a nationwide cross-section of middle-aged women. Those who consistently have higher than normal fasting blood sugars are perceived to be nearly a half year older than they really are, for every 18 points higher their average blood sugars are. So those with a pre-diabetic fasting blood sugar of like 120 milligrams per deciliter look about a year older than those regularly having a normal fasting blood sugar of around 75. Now, the Women's Health Initiative randomized nearly 50,000 postmenopausal women to a recommendation to eat the same lower-fat diet, yet there was no change in the incidence of skin cancer. This is not surprising given the poor adherence. Only 31% of the women in the intervention group complied with the dietary recommendations. It turns out healthy diets may only work if you actually eat them.
We would love it if you could share with us your stories about reinventing your health through evidence-based nutrition. Go to NutritionFacts.org/testimonials. We may be able to share it on social media to help inspire others. If you want to see any of the graphs, charts, graphics, images, or studies mentioned here, please go to the Nutrition Facts Podcast landing page. There you'll find all the detailed information you need, plus links to all the sources we cite for each of these topics. My latest book, How Not to Age, is out now. Check it out from your local public library. And of course, all the proceeds from the sale of all of my books goes directly to charity. NutritionFacts.org is a nonprofit, science-based public service where you can sign up for free daily updates on the latest in nutrition research with bite-sized videos and articles. Everything on the website is free. There are no ads, no corporate sponsorships, no kickbacks, strictly non-commercial. I'm not selling anything. I just put it up as a public service, as a labor of love, as a tribute to my grandmother, whose own life was saved with evidence-based nutrition.